So we have created this add property form using a template driven approach. Now we will add a new form to register a user, and we will create this form using reactive approach. We will implement everything that we have implemented using template driven approach in our previous video, like validating form, displaying errors, highlighting controls if an error occurred. In addition to that, we will also learn to create custom validators to validate the errors that are not possible using inbuilt validators. So let's quickly add a new menu item to register and login in place of this search box. Go to navigation bar component and remove this search box and add a register and login in place. So from now, I will skip explaining each and every line of code that we already have done in this course. It will save our time in learning process. In case someone has any question, you can comment on video. I will try my best to reply to your comments at earliest. Hope you are okay with that. So this is the final code here to add register and login link. And links are added here in our navigation bar. Let's add a new folder and name it user. And we will add all users related component under this folder. Add two components under this folder. One for user login and another for user register. Don't forget to add these two new components here in declaration array of the app module file. Also add routes for both of these components in app routes here so that we can navigate to these new components and map these two routes in our navbar component using router link. Also add router link active to highlight the active link. So navigation for these two components is now ready. Let's add a form in our user register component next. HTML structure of this form is similar to our add property form that we have added in our previous video. So it doesn't make any sense to explain each and every line in this video. I have provided a link to the code of this form below in description. You can just copy that and paste it here in HTML template of this user register component. So this is the final look of our user register form. Next, we'll start to add code to integrate this HTML form to bind with reactive form. Go to app module file. For template driven approach, we use form modules here to import array. And to enable reactive form, we need to add reactive form module here. Make sure this is imported here from @angular/forms. Now go to the user register component and declare a variable. Let's name it registration form, and type of this variable should be form group. It should be auto imported here from @angular/form. So what is form group? Form group is just a class to organize and manage the related form control in a form. So we can say it is just a wrapper around the collection of multiple form controls, and it helps to track the value and validation status of each control added under this class. So here in onInit method, we will instantiate registration form with new form group. If you look at this help, you can see this form group accepts three arguments. First one should be a JavaScript object of type abstract control. Second is validator or options. And third is async validator. This question mark after the argument name means a particular argument is optional. So first argument is mandatory and the other two are optional. So add a JavaScript object, and here we will add our first form control to this form group. So our first control in HTML template is username. Let's name it username and instantiate it with new form control. You can see all of the arguments of this constructor are optional. We will come to understand these later. For now, just instantiate this form control without any argument. So this is the basic requirement to add the instance of form in an Angular component. Now we can bind our HTML form with this registration form. So to bind our form control, Angular provides a directive named form control name. And using this, we can bind this input element with the form control we have defined in our form group here. And at form level, using property binding, we can bind our form group like this. And similarly, like template driven form, we can use ng-submit event to call a function in our component if a user submit this form. Let's add this function in our TypeScript file. And just display this registration form in console. Let's provide some value in name and press the save button. Perfect, we are getting form group in console, and it is almost similar to the one we have seen in ng-form in template driven form in our previous video. Here we are seeing a valid state of this form group, and as we have not added any validation yet on control, it is showing valid. And here in the value node, we can see the form control in the key value pair. Next, we'll look at how to add validation on our form control. If you remember, we had added validation attribute in our HTML template only. But in reactive approach, we do not add those attributes in HTML form. Instead, Angular provides an option to pass validator here in form control as an argument. If you see here, the first parameter is form state, where we can pass the default value or an object to pass default value and disabled state of that control. And the second argument here is validator. Let's set default value as mark and pass here validators. You can see Angular provides plenty of inbuilt validation function in this class. Let's select the required function to make this control mandatory. Let's test it. We are now getting mark as default name. And if you press the submit button, you can see in controls node, we are getting status as valid for this username form control. And if we set it to blank and resubmit our form, this status turned to invalid. And similarly, like template driven form, we are getting all the state linked classes here. We are not going into detail of these classes as we already have discussed in our previous video in detail. So you would have noticed that our template is much leaner now if we compare it with template driven form. We do not have to declare any template variable now to access this form in TypeScript file. And we do not have to mess up our template with lot of validation attributes. Hope you now understood the logic behind the naming convention Angular have used for these forms. So template driven form is called template driven because in this application logic flow from template to component or TypeScript file. While in reactive approach, logic flow from TypeScript to template. Let's add more validation on our form. Here in the email field, we need multiple validation. One, it should be mandatory, and also it should be an email ID. So how to add multiple validation on form control? Let's do not pass any default value in this field. We can pass null here as the first parameter. And if you look at the second argument of this function, it not only can accept a single validator function, it can accept an array of multiple validators as well. So define an array, and now we can pass multiple validators in this array. Let's bind it in our template with email input and also display form's value and status just below to this form temporarily. Just use a string interpolation and we can access our form here and print the value of this form. And for status, just display registration form dot valid to display the form level status. As we need to render it as JSON, Let's convert it to JSON using a pipe operator. We will understand the pipe in detail in this tutorial later. For now, it is sufficient to know that pipe can be used to transform value in templates. Add line break here as well to display this status in next line. So now we can see form status here without going to the console. You can see form status is false if email ID is blank. But as soon as it finds that email is valid, this form status becomes true. You can argue that san@g is not a valid email. I was also surprised that why it is valid email. So when I searched, I found that this is a valid email for localhost. I have provided a link to a wiki page, and you can find that admin@mailserver is a valid email address on that wiki page. Let's define the form controls for all the fields available in this form. I have made all of these fields mandatory and set min length to 8 for password and max length to 10 for mobile. Let's bind all these controls with the input fields in our template and fill up this form with all valid values. Perfect, our form status become valid, but we have not yet implemented any validation to compare password with confirm password. So here we need to implement validation across the field, and this is called cross field validation. Next, we will learn how to implement cross field validation using custom validator. As this is cross field validation, we cannot implement this validation at specific control. Instead, we need to use this validation at form group level. If you see in the second argument of form group, we can pass a validator or validator function. We will use this argument to check this cross field validation. As we do not have any inbuilt validator in Angular to compare two fields, we need to define our custom validator. Custom validator is nothing but just a function that should have an argument of any control type, and it should return a validator. Let's create our custom validator and name it password matching validator. And someone calling this function should be able to pass a control in this. And here, as we know, we are going to use it at form group level. Let's define form group as type. Second, it should return validators. And validator should either return null if condition is valid, or should return a JavaScript object with a key and its value if condition is not valid. So here in this function, we will match password and confirm password. As we have access to form group, we can get the value of control like this to get the value of password. And we can match it with the value of confirm password. So this condition will return true if both values are matched, and we want to return null in this case, as this is a valid condition for our form. If this condition is not true, we will return a JavaScript object, and here we can return a key. Let's name this key as not matched, and let's define the value of this key as true. Now we can pass this function here as an argument, and Angular automatically pass form group in this function. Let's test it. See form status here. When password and confirm password matching, form's valid state become true, and if it is not matched, it becomes false. Let's look at how this error appear in console. See, if password is mismatched, we are getting this in error node, and this is what we are returning in our custom validator function when password and confirm password is not matched here. So this is how we can implement a custom validator function when inbuilt validator do not fulfill our requirement. Next, we will see how to display validation error in our template. We already have seen that in template driven form, if we were to access the state of any input control, we had to define a template variable to pass ngModel, and that template variable we could use to get the current state of that control. But in reactive form, it is simpler, and the same can be achieved with lesser code. Let's add a span to display error. And here in ngif, we can use our registration form, and it provides a get method where we can pass the ID of any control defined under that form to get the access of that control. And this control provides plenty of methods and properties we can use for our purpose. Here we will use valid property to check if this control is valid or not. And similarly, we can check if it is touched or untouched. Put a not operator here as we need to display this error when it is not valid. Let's test it. So if we move the cursor in the input box and move out without entering any value, we are getting this error message. Let's add a class to display this error in red color. We already have done it in add property component. We can copy the same CSS from there and we can paste it here in the CSS file. And here we can add this error block class here in this span. And you can see it is perfectly showing error in red color. But this is not a good idea to copy and paste it in different component, as we need to use these CSS class throughout the application. And also we will add more CSS to change the appearance of control further in this course. Let's add it at global level instead to keep it at component level. Let's add form.css under the assets folder to add the styles related to the forms. So copy and paste that CSS here in form.css file. And to make it accessible globally, we need to import this form.css here in style.css. Now we can remove it from component level and it will work perfectly in our user register form. Let's remove it from the add property component as well. You can see we are repeating this statement multiple times here for validation. Let me show you another way to keep this template a little more linear. Angular provides getter method that we can use to expose any value as property. These are just a special kind of function prefixed with get. And the restriction on these function is we cannot have an argument in it and it must return some value. So we can define the getter method for username and whatever we are doing in template to get the access of form control, we can do that here. And we can return it as form control. Now we can just directly use that getter method here just like other properties. Let's replace it here as well. You can see now our code is more readable. Similarly, we can add getter method for all of these form controls. Next, let's look at how to display different error messages in case multiple validators are applied on a form control. So email address should be mandatory and also it should be a valid email ID. So first we can just check if email is not valid and it should be touched. And then we can add one more span here. And we can check specific error like this. Every form control provides a function called hasError. And we can pass the specific error as string here as parameter in this function. Similarly, we can check if email has an error related to email. We can display different error messages for the same. I can see spelling mistake here. So let's check it. Perfect. We are getting different error messages for both different types of errors. Similarly, we can apply it on other input control as well. Here you can see I have checked password related errors differently. I have not used hasError method. Instead, I have used error property provided by the form control, and as it returns an array of errors, we can check if it contains a specific kind of error by passing the error code here. And also we can simply use dot and error code like this. So these are three different ways we can use to validate specific error in form control. Now come to the confirm password. Here for mandatory field validation, it is similar as we have done on other inputs above. But notice the password mismatch error. We have checked error at form level, not at control level, because this error we will get at form group level. And also notice we have not kept this error under this span as we have done it for other input validation, because we need to check this validation only once when confirm password is valid. Otherwise it will not work. Let's check it. So we are getting please confirm password error if it is blank. And as soon as we start to type in this field, we can see we are seeing password not matched error. And if it is matched, error gone. So hope now you are aware how both template driven and reactive form works. So basically everything that can be done in reactive form can also be done in template driven form and vice versa. Although few people may find template driven form easier to implement, but you end up writing more code with template driven form in comparison of reactive form. And you will also have lesser control over the form controls in template driven form. Next, we will understand few more concepts about forms, and then we will understand the advantage of using reactive form over the template driven form. So see you in next video. Stay tuned.